Hockey is more than just a game. For many, it's a lifestyle. The sweat-soaked smell of the dressing room. The logo that represents an unbreakable bond. The roar of the crowd. Winter means hockey, and hockey means everything. Some say Canadians are born on skates, but for Windsor, Ontario native Zack Kassian, ice hockey didn't start until a later age.
I didn't start hockey until I was 8 years old. I played a lot of street hockey and things like that, but one day out of the blue, I went to my mom and said I wanted to play ice hockey, and she made it happen. And from there, you couldn't get me off the ice. I fell in love with the game. I can't pinpoint just one thing. I think just for the most part, just going out there, playing with the puck, skating around, I just had a real joy for the game.
In today's NHL, Kassian is known around the league as a well-rounded forward, but he's also a force to be reckoned with.
Center for Zack Kassian. Big collision right in front of the Flames bench.
He doesn't have a stick. He's able to get it back now. Big hit by Kassian.
To his game along with the size. Back behind, a big hit by Kassian. Kelly, as Stone took a huge hit in the corner. Was that Kassian again? We're going to have a tilt here. Borowiecki trying to get his left hand free, misses with a left hook, eats a left hook from Kassian, and then more wrestling, and Kassian powers him to the ice.
Kassian start a fight, and look at Kassian come with the left hand. Zack Kassian getting up and throwing lefts. He's not finished, and finally the takedown on Manson.
It's a message. Don't think we're the same old Oilers that you've been seeing the last number of years.
Zack started to develop his identity as a player when he was a 16-year-old playing with the Peterborough Petes of the Ontario Hockey League.
Coach started to work with me, coaches that we had in Peterborough, kind of describing what I kind of had to do to get to the next level. Because growing up, yeah, it's every kid's dream to play in the NHL, but I wasn't sure. I didn't really know. I just played the game and played the game as hard as I could and wanted to see what happened. But as I got older, and I think in Peterborough it started when I thought maybe I could make a living doing this, and that's when things kind of took a curve and really got serious.
Kassian continued to polish his game, and in 2009 in Montreal, Quebec, was rewarded by being selected 13th overall by the Buffalo Sabres in the NHL entry draft.
People try to tell you to relax and just enjoy the moment, but when it's happening, it is pretty stressful. You have your friends and family there, which is awesome, but when you're sitting there waiting for your name to get called, it seems like every 2 minutes takes an hour. Time drags on, but when you finally hear your name called, it's a pretty special moment to hear it and to spend it with your family. It was the day I'm always going to remember. In your mind, you know there's a lot of work still to be done, but you really don't know how much and how hard you have to work to get to the NHL. Getting drafted is one thing, but to get here is another, and then to stay here is a whole other level. So that was a pretty special moment, but after the draft, that's when things really started to shape up, and that's when things really had to start to get to work.
Over the next two seasons, Zack would spend time with his hometown team, Windsor Spitfires, before making his professional debut with the Portland Pirates of the American Hockey League. In 2011, Kassian moved to the Rochester Americans, and later that year, he made his NHL debut with the Buffalo Sabres.
I remember I was, a lot of nerves were going through, but it was one of those things, once the game started, just went out and played, and I ended up getting an assist in my first game, lucky, but that kind of settled the nerves a bit, and that's when I really started to know I wanted to play here full time, and I wanted to earn every bit of it. I think when you get there, you try to look at the guys that have been there the longest. That's what I kind of did, and I didn't so much ask that many questions. I kind of just would always keep an eye on how they were preparing and how they handled things. And in Buffalo, it was the Thomas Vaneks, the Millers, the goalie Miller. Roy, Pominville, there was a lot of guys that are still playing in the NHL today that were good players, and I kind of just watched them, how they worked in practice and in games.
Kassian's life as a Sabre was short-lived, only playing 27 games in a Buffalo uniform before being traded to the Vancouver Canucks.
Complete shock. I was on the, I was in the truck heading to the airport. I believe we were flying up to California, and I got a call from Darcy Aguirre, and he told me I've been traded. to the Vancouver Canucks, and pretty shocked. Wasn't expecting it, but once I got to Vancouver, I was pretty excited about the opportunity. Really enjoyed my time there. It was something that I'll always remember. I was played 3.5 years there, so it was kind of where a good chunk of my professional career was.
In the summer of 2015, Zack was sent to the Montreal Canadiens, but before he could join the Habs, the young forward found himself in trouble with the NHL after a car accident in early October. A few days later, Kassian entered stage 2 of the NHL's substance abuse program.
It had to happen, sadly. Like I said, it had to happen. If it wasn't then, it was going to come eventually. I just wish I would have had the mindset I do today. Then I wish I had my mindset that I do now in Buffalo. Who knows? But there was nothing really to say there. It had to happen, sadly, and that's that. It was frustrating, but all in all, it ended up working out.
2 months later, Zack completed the program and was reinstated by the National Hockey League. With his career up in the air, Kassian received a phone call that would give him one last shot to continue his NHL career.
I wasn't sure what was really going to happen. I wasn't sure if I was going to get picked up or not, to be blatantly honest. But when Peter reached out, I realized I might be getting one more chance, and I wasn't going to screw this up.
On December 28th of 2015, Kassian's prayers were answered in a deal that would bring him to Edmonton in exchange for goaltender Ben Scrivens.
I believe he understands where he is in his career right now, personally and professionally, and giving him an opportunity to recover and supporting him while he does that, hopefully we'll end up with a player that can contribute at this level. But that's really up to him and our development team down in the American League right now.
And knowing that there will be risk attached, I felt satisfied with completing this transaction. And frankly, the one thing that Zack said to me is, like, I could promise you things, but I'm going to have to show them. So
as soon as I got that call, it was a very short call between me and Peter. We talked about how it's really a matter of me doing instead of telling him over the phone. And it kind of ended like that. And from there on out, it was up to me to prove him.
Over the last season and a half, Zack Kassian has found a home in Edmonton. The 26-year-old continues to overcome obstacles and does it all with a smile on his face.
I've always been a guy that's smiling and having fun. It's the NHL. Obviously, things aren't going to go your way. You're going to have wins and losses, bad games, good games. But all in all, we're in the NHL. You come here, you work hard every day, but enjoy it, because like many people have told me, the career it goes quick, and next thing you know, you're done and it's over. So I just try to enjoy it every day. We got a good group of guys, which makes that a lot easier. And we're doing well this year, so that it's kind of icing on the cake. But they have something special here. And when you have a guy like Connor McDavid running the ship, it's one of those things where you want to stick around and be a part of the future.